Okay, so in a review, we have added on these hinges, which are attached to these foam board pieces with popsicle sticks on the inside so that the mousetrap doesn't eat them alive. And then they're going to flip up, getting the balls when we put the Velcro here. And we also added a little bit of Velcro here and here because our car was very close to the bottom balls on either side. So hopefully that'll just scoop those up. And then...
Why are they not parallel? Why are they, like, splitting apart from each other?
The reason we angled them is because when we tested it out, when it flung this way, it actually hit off the hill. So
hit
we
the ball
figured...
off the hill.
Yeah.
You didn't say ball.
You can edit that out, my friend. So it hits the ball. It had hit the ball off the hill. So when we angled it like this, when it flings forward, if the Velcro does not work, they'll still stay on our side of the hill, gaining points for us. And then we're going to add mouse traps right here and here. Like this, for example. Actually, this direction.
No, it's the other way.
This way?
Yep.
Yeah?
That's why we figured out.
They would be this direction set so that when they release, it would send them that way.
Scooping the balls back.
Grabbing the balls and giving our team the win.
Damn it.
Was that the same one? Yeah.
Here it is, the completed car.
What the? God damn it!
Tuesday, we took our Conquer the Hill project to school.
It wasn't
that good. we've begun to disassemble it because we're changing a few things. Basically, what had happened was we had placed this on the hill. It fit in, barely. And then we pulled the starting string back, let go of the starting string, and it didn't go anywhere. When I pushed down on the back so that the front was lifted up, the wheels would spin. So clearly we didn't have enough force. The mousetraps didn't supply enough force to propel our car forward. So we're switching our power to rubber band power. But if I recall correctly, we have removed the mousetraps. I don't know if I should do that yet. We should get a good look at that. That's a good look. And we've attached rubber bands in place of the mouse traps, both on top, well not on top, but we took the mouse traps from the top off, and we rubber band the bottom to get hopefully a more powerful force than the mouse traps provided. You can see they've got the basic band loop on the back axle tied to the eye hooks that are holding the front wheels. There are two rubber bands long, tied together. We also had to build a new wheel because one of them broke while we were removing the mouse traps. Otherwise, not much is different. The basic plan, I think, is going to remain the same in that we're going to have two main pieces to get the balls. They're going to be columns right here. And then we plan to make some sort of thing that swings out from the middle to stop the vehicle from going too far to the opposite side. And that's our current plan.
So, Brian, what's the new design for the thing that gets the balls?
All right, well, basically what our new design is we're going to have a string attached to this front axle. So as the wheels spin, it's going to pull the string, which is going to be connected to this piece of foam board, which raises the foam board up, and thus will collect the balls for us. This is just our prototype here. What we're going to change around a bit is we're going to have like a T-shape here, so that it gets the balls on both sides. Also...
And the Velcro in the front on either corner is...
Yes, this Velcro here is going to get the balls on the bottom.
The lower balls.
We are going to modify this a bit. This is another prototype. Of wing things. So as this comes up, it will knock the wing things, and we'll get the wings to stop right here with a dowel that will stop from going any further. And this will prevent the car from going to the other side of the hill. And if things work out perfectly, it may even help to push the car back.
How are the the coat hanger going to activate to go all the way around?
Basically, as this is being pulled up,
as the foam board goes up, it'll hit the.
It's going to help
hang
it around.
Paul, could you explain what we've just done on the car?
I most definitely could, Skyler. We've added this screw here to the bottom of the car, giving us another place to put a rubber band, which is attached to the dowel. Like the other
More than one rubber band, but.
Oh.
We
didn't talk about
stators yet. We also added these staple barriers at the back of our car because when Brian was testing it out during his class, it did not fit by the slightest amount, and this will give us that much more room without adding too much to the length of the car. Getting it out of the starting zone.
Sounds good.
It does.
It is.
Very
good.
Yeah.
Okay, so our original system for moving the vehicle was with mouse traps. They didn't supply enough power to move the car up the hill. So we're going with a different system of rubber bands. But once we installed the rubber bands, every time we tried to test the vehicle, the wheels would spin out. So as you can see, we've have hot glued about a quarter inch of sandpaper around the back wheels, which will be supplying the power to move the car. And this is our first trial run with the sandpaper on. Cole's walking the dog right now. Here we go.
Okay, so after the last filming, we've made a few changes, but we didn't get the room recorded because we weren't all there. The changes have been that the foam board, which we were originally going to have two that come up and swing around, the coat hangers, don't exist anymore. Now we just have one T-shaped piece of foam board that's being pulled up by a string. We tried to do that on the real hill though, and it requires way too much force, and it just, if we push it up, it's too high, so... What Brian's doing today at his house is he's gonna put a mouse trap under the foam board to give it a little push up. So when the wheel turns with the string that is pulling up the foam board, it's gonna be easier to pull up and it should actually work. And also, he is putting on the coat hangers with the film canisters. So that when the foam board hits the coat hangers, they're going to spin around and hit the side of the where the balls are, and so our car doesn't go to the other person's side, inadvertently scoring points for their team.